Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. As you can see, it's a little bit overcast today in Oregon, but you know what? It's great for RVing because it's not too hot and it's not raining. So come and get an RV at the RV Corral. See Joe Bass. I'm going to go over a couple of units today. This one here is a Kit Cordova, which is one of their nicest units. It's a smooth side. It's 27 foot long with a slide. So gives you lots of room for an older unit. They want to move this unit. They got it priced to sell. Just call Joe Bass. I'll give you the price for it. As you can see, it's got a solid fiberglass front cap. And this just came in about a day or two ago, so you're getting a fresh look at this unit. Lots of storage up front. Has electric jacks. Has a nice big awning that goes across this side. Covers up the doorway and propane tanks, so you can get to the propane tanks if it is drizzling a little bit out here without getting wet. The decals on the side are in very nice condition. I just got done going over this coach really well, and it looks like the decals are in very good shape. They're not peeling, they're not checked. You're getting a good unit with this. I was also looking at it, and it looks like it's been sealed somewhat recently. So somebody's taking the time to maintain this rig. So with this Cordova, you're getting a really nice, well-maintained, older rig. Dual 7.5-gallon propane tanks. You're also getting a pass-through storage area right here. It goes from one side all the way to the other. I'm a big bass fisherman, so this is a great place to store fishing rods if you want to. Also, the model on this, to be exact, is called a 27BE. Or BF, and it's a rear kitchen unit, and we'll see that as we get on the inside. Come around this side here, we've got a water heater right here. This is a gas electric 6-gallon hot water heater. Why is that important? Why am I pointing that out? Gas electric is terrific if you get into a campsite that has power. You don't have to run off your propane unless you want to. It's got a little toggle switch on the inside, which most people don't know. It's right there. It's a little black toggle switch that has an on and off switch. You turn that little toggle switch on, this baby heats off electricity. However, if you want to heat off propane and electric, it heats at 16.2 gallons per hour recovery, which means you'll never run out of hot water when you're showering, when you're out camping. Terrific unit. It's got a rear solid fiberglass cap as well. Most of these older units are just rolled fiberglass front and back, but this actually has solid fiberglass rear and front cap. Got a ladder going up the back, so we know that we got a good solid structure across the back with a rack up on top, so you could store boxes and bags up there. Got a nice spare tire rack here. As we come over to this side, you will see the slide. And as you can see, it's a fairly decent sized slide. This is approximately 12 foot long, which gives you a lot of space on the inside, which you'll see in a little bit. Got a nice big storage area underneath the sofa on the inside, and I'll show you that. Again, this unit has not been touched yet by our service department, but just be assured, these folks are going to go through this unit. It's going to be spotless clean. And you are going to love it when you see it. And they're going to go through and make sure all the major appliances for you are working. So your water heater is going to work. Your air conditioner is going to work. Your refrigerator is going to work. Your furnace is going to work. Your water pump is going to work. And I'm going to make sure everything possible in this coach that has something in there is going to be working. So make sure you talk to Joe Bass and I'll make sure for you. As we come around this side here, there's the switch right there for the leveling jacks up front. And up top here, at the very top up there, you can see gutters and downspouts. So this has gutters and downspouts down both sides, which actually locates the water to certain areas and drains down, rather than just spilling over the edge of the coach. So let's go take a look at the inside. As you come into the inside, you're going to see the sofa right here. And that area of storage that I showed you on the outside. So underneath that sofa from the outside, you can access it as well. It's got these light switches right here that control the lights. Right now the batteries are shut off, but these actually control the light over here And this one here controls these lights over here. Nice big sofa. This is also a scissor bed. So if you're familiar with a scissor bed is not a hide-a-bed, but it still makes into another sleeping area. So this will all end up laying flat if you want it to. Comes with its old recliner right here. Matches all the interior materials. And instead of a dinette, which was pretty common for this year, these folks opted for the table and chairs. And that's nice because this table is movable. You can move it anywhere you want to. Gives you a lot more room in between here. So you can scoot these chairs out as needed. Nice big storage area here in the kitchen. As you can see, all the nice cupboards. These are all solid wood cupboards up front, solid wood doors. These right here, nice solid cabinets. You know, that's something I like to do. I like to really bang on stuff. And this is a solid unit. Lots of big drawers in the kitchen area. 1, 2, 3. Then you got more storage here. Dual sink. Porcelain sink, mind you. Not plastic, not fiberglass. Porcelain sink. Microwave here. Looks like a newer style. I'm sure this is not original. So these folks have replaced this microwave somewhere along the way. But look at this thing here. You got a side-by-side fridge. So one side is freezer, the other side is fridge. Man, lots of room. And I don't know if you've ever RV'd before, but one of the biggest problems we have is the refrigerator is never big enough. We always got more food. If we stay for a week at a time, these get awfully small. But with this one, you're getting a side-by-side fridge. Freezer, this whole side. Refrigerator, this whole side. We also have a nice little stereo system here. Plays a little bit of music. Very nice unit. More storage up here. You know, you're going to like this kit, Cordova. I do. It's an older fifth wheel you can get into fairly inexpensive. Come see Joe Bass, RV Corral. I'll show you this unit. You're going to love it if you're looking for an older unit. And 27 foot long, so you're not really long either. Come see Joe Bass. If you ask for Joe Bass, I'll make sure that you get a free gift. Thank you.